Hey, I am Chris. Welcome to my channel. Let's take a look at the three different type of references in Microsoft Excel, and I will give you examples of how to use each one when I'm going through here. Let's dive in right now. So the three references are relative reference, absolute reference, and mixed reference. The relative reference is the one you see all the time, you use frequently. There are no dollar signs in the cell reference. Here's an easy example. I have this workbook open. I want to jump to a specific file. Right-click one of the navigation arrows. All your worksheets appear. I'm going to jump over here to the if worksheet. Click OK. And now I'm on the if worksheet. So here's relative reference. I've got four quarters of data for different reps. I want to sum up their amount over in column F, and then I'm going to autofill it down. Either auto sum up in the editing group or alt equal, control enter will leave you in the same cell. Enter would have moved me down, and I would have had to click back on it. Crosshairs, but look at my cell reference. This is the sum of B8 through E8. There are no dollar symbols in there. Crosshairs and double click. I'm going to press the delete key. Honestly, if this was me, I would have just highlighted these and now done alt equal. Just a cool little trick there. That is relative reference. No dollar symbols. We use it all the time in Excel. Here is absolute cell reference. I can already tell you a cool tip about absolute cell reference. Usually there is a number just sitting out there by itself. For me in this example, for absolute cell reference, it is cell B4, $8,800. So we're only going to give them, I'm making up this commission number, we're only going to give them a $2,000 commission if their total in column F is greater than 8,800. I'm over in cell G8. This is an if statement. Equals if cell F8 is greater than cell B4. Now, here is where you have to make cell B4 absolute reference. I need a dollar sign in front of the B and after the B, or you could say before the number 4. I'm just going to hit the F4 function key on my keyboard. If you're on a laptop, it may be function F4. So there's absolute cell reference right there, two dollar signs. If I keep doing the F4 key, there's one mixed. I'm heading there in just a second. There's a second mixed reference. And then still pressing F4, I'm back to relative reference. So what I do want to end up though is cell B4, absolute reference. Don't change it, don't move it when I copy or autofill it down or across, whichever direction you want to go. If I did not do absolute reference, one down would have said F9 greater than B5, F10 greater than B6. So that is why I made that absolute. I believe I said we're going to give them $2,000. That is the value if true, comma, value if false. I could give them zero, but if you want to put text in here, I'm going to do double quotes. No bonus commission. There you go. It'll close by itself. Control enter. $12,450 is definitely greater than cell B4, $8,800, so they got $2,000. Crosshairs, just double click. All the numbers that you see, $2,000, are over $8,800, but here's $7,000, so therefore, no bonus commission. If I decide to change this number, this is what's cool about relative reference, I'm going to make it $6,000. $950. Remember the person was 7,000. They just got the bonus. So there you go. I'm going to undo Control Z back to 8,800. So there is your absolute cell reference with cell B4, two dollar signs right there. The last one is mixed reference. I'm going to do this twice to explain how it works, and then finally I'll come back and do it with an actual accounting exercise, vertical analysis on an income statement. So I'm going to insert a new worksheet. I am making this exercise up. I just came back from a conference, EA Ignite, in Baltimore, Maryland. One session was on mastering Microsoft OneDrive, but the other session was on analyzing financial data in Excel. So this was part of it. So here was my mixed reference example. We're having a conference, and I want to list the number of people across the top. I don't know how many people are going to attend. I'm going to start off with 100. Maybe we get 120, highlight those. And maybe the most number of people that will show up are 240. Never had this conference before. Now the question is, what price are we going to charge? Let's say we're charging, I am making this number up, $1,400. Maybe we're going to charge $1,600. Highlight those two. Crosshairs. And we'll stop at $2,600. I'll make this money just so you can see it. No big deal there. Here's mixed reference. I need to take the 100, multiply it times the $1,400, then the 120 times the 1,400. And so you're saying, Chris, we'll make the 1,400 absolute cell reference like you just did in the if statement. No, because then I need to fill it down to the 1,600. Absolute reference will always reference cell B2. So this is a mixed, and there's going to be two mixed. Equal the 1,400. Right now it's relative. I'm going to go ahead and mess this exercise up so you can see what it does. B2 times C1. That number is absolutely correct right there. The problem is all these other numbers are incorrect. We're not making 16 million because it took 120 and it multiplied it times the 1,400. So I hope you see why that is not correct. So here's the correct one right here. Equals, I'm going to take B2. I'm going to press the F4 function key once. That's absolute. Don't want it. I'm going to press it a second time. That is mixed reference right there. $1 sign. I am telling Excel that I want to freeze row 2, but that is not correct here. I'm going to do another F4. Notice the dollar sign is only in front of column B. I am freezing column B. But the rows can change. It can go B2, B3, B4, B5, on and on. Times C1. And again, the F4 function key, there's absolute reference. That is what I want. I want row 1 to be frozen because it's going to go across row 1, C1, D1, E1, F1. But row 1 is not going to change, but the column will change. Control Enter. Perfect. There's the formula again in the formula bar. Autofill to the right. Let's widen all the columns. There you go. Obviously, the same price, the more number of people, more money we make in revenue. There you go. B2 times J1. All these numbers are correct. Select them. Autofill crosshairs, double click. The highest number when I double click should be cell J8 because I'm multiplying $2,600 times 240 people. There you go. Just checking a couple of these real quick. B8 times C1. Everything is good. So there was mixed reference, and there's actually two mixed references. We used them both right here in cell C2. So how does mixed reference tie into vertical analysis of an income statement? Let me just pop over in here real quick. When you do vertical analysis on an income statement, you need to reference one number in every line item. I want to show percentages. So what is 2,800 of 600,000? And then what is this 320 of the 600,000? So I'm always referencing 600,000. So before you say, Chris, that sounds like absolute reference, I could do that, but then I want to do it again for this other company that's got income statement numbers. So it is going to be equal B5 divided by B5. This should be your 100% whenever you're doing vertical analysis on an income statement. That top line item number should be 100%. I am not going to absolute reference it. I am going to make it I believe that is it. If not, I'll fix it real quick. Let's make it a percentage. Crosshairs, pull it down. That is incorrect. So even I get to make a mistake. Right on camera, we'll leave that. Maybe, maybe not, we'll see. 100%. Now we're in business. 100% down to, so our net income of $120,000 is 20% of our revenue. That is why this is cool. Grab these numbers, right click. Here's why I didn't do absolute, because I couldn't do this trick right here. I'm gonna do a copy and paste. And now these numbers are also correct. So there's another example of why mixed reference is so cool. I know there were only two companies. I probably could have used absolute and edit the formula real quick. But what if I got six companies going across here? I don't want to sit here doing all that. So absolute reference, mixed reference, relative reference. In case you're wondering, if you want to know more about them, up at the top is the search bar. And I believe I've already got this typed in here, switching between relative, absolute, and mixed. My initial search wasn't that, but that is actually what they call this under Get Help. Here it is. This is Microsoft's help. It pulls right up in Microsoft Excel, and it is telling you relative, absolute, and mixed, which I just told you, and then it's going into details about them. I actually feel like I did a better job, but in case you want the help files, here they are right here. I appreciate your time. Hope you had a great session with me in this little video. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you.